group of people are just walking along the nice California beach in Venice here, just stop and look at a chalk mural on the wall. For me, like, that's what art is. It just proves that art isn't for the well-educated or the intelligent, but people like you. Now I call this piece the Ancient Greek Arty Chicks. I did a ton of research. I took a book out of the library and everything. The blonde in the middle isn't quite right. Ah, never mind. The important thing is that we are all gathered together to take part in an artistic experience. The girl up front and center is all wrong. Destroys the whole composition. I ruin everything I do. I'll never get it right. Never, never, never. Ah, mega bummer. What the hell? Guys like me shouldn't dream anyways.
Inspired by a muse. Well, otherwise, how could there be an artist's ego?
Right you are. To pronounce one's museness is as forbidden as creating art or loving a mortal.
Loving a mortal? Good one.
But what can you do to remain unnoticed?
Hmm.
I shall go in disguise.
A disguise? Tell us now this disguise.
First, I will not call myself Clio. I will call myself Kira.
Oh, you've thrown off the track now.
Secondly, I will wear roller skates and leg warmers.
You shall be as current as today's headlines.
And thirdly, I will sport an Australian accent. Good eye, mate. Over here. Good eye.
Oh.
By
the gods, that is an impenetrable disguise.
I tell you, sisters, by the fires of Hephaestus, I mean by all the fires of all the shrimp on the barbie, I shall help the city Malone to fulfill his destiny.
Huzzah!
Sisters Nine, we must toil in this area and in this era.
Sisters Nine?
Dear Melpomene, do you not recognize your own sisters, Urania on keyboards? And Polyhymnia on synth?
And guitar?
Oh, that's Bob.
Hi, Bob!
Sisters all, let us announce our callings and rejoice to the new world!
Clio!
Muse of history and leader of the muses, hereafter known as Kira!
Clio!
Muse of lyrics and erotica.
New Turkey!
Muse of music.
Melpomene!
Muse of tragedy.
Talia!
Muse of comedy!
My sisters and I begin our task.
Suddenly came the dawn
from the night.
Suddenly I was born
into life.
Been in your mind. You know I will be kind. I'll be guide. stand in our way. You have to believe we are magic. Don't let your rain ever stray. And if all your hopes are blind,
you look just like the girl in the mural.
Only prettier and thinner. I'll bring all your dreams alive for you. I'll bring all your dreams alive for you. Sonny Malone, I'm gonna make you the idol of all the cousins in the world as you achieve great artistic creations.
Wait a minute, I know who you are. Are you a Scientologist?
No, my religion's much older than that, my sister.
And I. Oh, so you're Catholic. I do have one idea. It's kind of stupid.
Share with me now.
I thought maybe for one moment I can make all the arts converge in one place. Painting, music, dancing, and maybe even athletics.
You mean?
Yes. I would like to open a roller disco.
Oh, timeless.
Timeless. You know what? Even though I was suicidal about 7 minutes ago, I think I can do it. Oh my gosh. I can do it.
Old, ancient, and potentially senile sister. I know that to create art is forbidden by Zeus himself, almost as forbidden as falling in love with a mortal. But my work with the one they call Sonny Malone is purely selfish, for Zeus has appeared to me in my dreams and told me one day that I will inspire a work so wondrous that I will be granted the gift of Xanadu.
Xanadu?
Xanadu? So grand, none of us truly know what it means.
Yes! And Zeus tells me he will be sending a sign. So away I go to inspire great work. Funny thing about these mortals, they know they will die, yet they are so determined to create. The human spirit, it is called. It gives me great feelings of... Oh, Irito, what is the word for which I search? Something so grand and so earnest, yet so preposterous that it has to make one laugh. What does one call that?
Andrew Lloyd Webber?
There we are! The human spirit gives me great feelings of Andrew Lloyd Webber. Ah, well, the mortal Sunny Malone approaches. Away I must fly.
Sweet sisters of inspiration.
Listen to our various charges.
Clyde, pass him hither.
I'm already hither.
I crave a word with you. I need not tell you, as firstborn, I was entitled to the position of leader of the muses.
And yet Zeus did not grant thusly. What gives?
I did lay down with Achelous.
The river god?
Oh, he was a river god. And he was a rambling man. And he, my baby daddy, he left me four daughters. Mope, Pessene, Alagope, Philexipaya.
Like a Jennifer or a Susan would have killed you.
Oh, my daughters, the sirens. For years, I instructed them in the lute and the flute. And now, they sit by the seaside, singing and playing and luring sailors to their rocky deaths. Yes, my daughters, the sirens.
The sirens?
They never call.
And Zeus did not grant you with the leader position because he felt that you were too busy with your children. So he gave the role to Clio.
Apparently there is no success nor joy for you nor I. And now Clio is to be granted Xanadu. With that I forgot, I would smite her.
It's your sister. You are such a... Yo, what's the word I'm looking for?
Bo woman. Bo woman.
By Zeus's decree, be put to death.
Hey, 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 hey! Oh, come on, daughter, come join your mother on your knees, spirit melody.
You're an evil woman.
Evil woman, have you done me wrong? But now you're trying to wail a different song.
Painting, it turned out to be Kira. Wait, who am I talking to? Wow, it's you.
It's me, hi.
But this place could be amazing. It could be the perfect place to open my Apex of All the Arts, my roller disco. But what to call it?
How about Sunny's Place?
righteous. Well, let's chill out. I think I see the one marquee in the bushes over there.
What does it say?
It says Kira. The name on the sign is the Ex-Anadu.
Oh! I know her! The Xanadu! Xanadu. Sonny, that sign, it's a sign!
Well, of course it is, silly.
Yes, I just mean silly, but Xanadu.
Look, Kira, I don't even know you, but let me just tell you, you are probably the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Thank you! And you're probably right.
I wonder who owns this old white elephant. Oh, but wait, there's a sign on the door. I wonder how to get a hold of him.
If only there were a book, a magic book, that listed all the locations in Los Angeles and had their phone numbers next to it.
Yeah.
And if that book had pages the color of amber?
I know! I'll look it up in the phone book!
I got it. You're brilliant!
It's Remy! And she walks in. Suddenly he rolls. I'm taking in my wish to you to my name is Sonny Malone. I'd like to rent this large auditorium for an event I'm planning. Sure, I can be there in 5 minutes. Where are you? Got it. Haunting Melrose, a haunted past Los Angeles, a haunted past Brenda. And how can I feel all the matters? And I rely on anything you say. Talk to the landlord of this place. He has an office in downtown LA.
Downtown LA?
Don't worry. You make me feel so invincible. I feel like I'm going to downtown LA without a weapon. Why do I feel so alive when you're near? There's no way any hurt can get through.
A passing fancy. And what a cloud of mortal. Where do they journey off to?
I wonder out loud. When I say $1 million, I mean $1 million. Miss Frayling-Hyson, will you please send in my next appointment? I believe it's a Mr. Sonny Malone, an associate. McGuire here. I will destroy you. Have a nice day. You must be Sonny Malone. Where's the associate?
She'll be here in a little bit.
Last time I saw a guy dressed like you, he tried to sell me a nickel bag. I still don't know what a nickel bag is. Okay, that was a warm part of chit-chat part of this meeting. Why are you here?
I'd like to talk to you about renting one of your spaces.
You'll have to be a little more specific. I own many buildings here in the Los Angeles area.
I'm here to talk to you about one you own down on
Fairfax. Oh, yes, I'm tearing that whole block down, turning it into condos.
Well, there's a theater there. It's called, you know, the Xanadu.
The Xanadu? God, I haven't thought about that fire trap in years. But what for? You gonna run movies there?
Well, yeah, movies and live theater performances.
And there will also be an art gallery. Visionary, but I mean in a good way. We developers love the arts.
Really?
Sure, nothing turns a crap neighborhood around like the arts, and you can kick out the artists and sell for more to the urban professionals.
Oh. Well, there's also an athletic element to this endeavor. We would like to open
a roller disco. Look, you're wearing roller skates to a business meeting. You're either an idiot or a genius. How much money you got to spend?
I was thinking you'd give it to me for free.
You're an idiot. Me, give you one of my properties. For free.
Well, it would have all the arts in one space, so people
say
could go.
Say that free part again, because that's just comedy in a bag there.
Well, besides, you're not using it, and it shouldn't be torn down. It's a great old auditorium.
I should know. I built it.
You did?
My first building, I never opened it.
You built that theater, and it's been empty all of these years? Why didn't you open
it? Why don't you stop talking, and I don't throw something at you? Now go away. I have people on telephones I have to yell at.
Noted.
How's it going, Mai?
You. I said you'd be back in. No. It can't be you.
Sorry?
No, I'm sorry. You just remind me of someone I knew when I was a much younger man. Like this guy over here, only I didn't show so much leg.
Hey.
Why do you look so familiar?
They call me Kira.
Which is good, because that's your name.
Kira. Sorry, lady. You just look like somebody I once knew. Now, get out of here, the both of you. Forget about the Xanadu. I'm tearing the whole place down. No other place could take off my mind. So refined. Much too kind. I have to warn you. I'm never gonna set you free. Cause I was born to love you for eternity. Whenever you're away from me, whenever you go. Never far away from me. I want you to know. I close my eyes, dear, and suddenly I'm where you are. You better not say, cause I'll never be far away.
Fall apart, dear, if you let this feeling end. Don't break a heart.
far away from me. I want you to know. I only have to close my eyes here. It's only I'm where you are. Never be far away. Ba ba da ba da 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 da.
This clarinet player laying down the last pin on the construction.
How'd you ever afford such an expensive place with only the dough you get from playing a licorice stick?
That song I wrote for you, the Duke says it's solid gone.
But do you really think I'm a sophisticated lady?
None other, Duchess. None other.
That's the first song I want to hear when we open this place. Once we've built this theater, there'll be big band concerts in here. Then you want to be jumping with jitterbugs.
Only now that I've looked over the books, let's not open right now.
What?
Well, the timing's all wrong. We're fighting the Germans and Japanese, and times is tough. We've got to be a little tight with our bread.
And you think just because there's a war and a depression that it's not time for art? You don't want to open the theater till times are better because we'll lose money now?
Bingo.
Yeah. Oh, I dig, and I hope you dig that I have to leave you. The man I want is the man who has the nerve.
I don't get you.
I'm going to leave you, Danny. What? And I won't come back. And in 35 years from now, when a young man comes and wants to rent this theater, you will put aside your greed and help him.
Wait a minute. You didn't say that when we broke up.
But I'm saying it now during this flashback. Go help Sonny. If you ever loved me, you would give the kid a break.
What?
The path back to me is in that theater.
How can?
Better never stray, 'cause I'll never be far.
Fall in love in the most lethal way known.
We shall make them complete one another.
Girl, you are a menace.
Off you go. Let us complete our evil mission. No. Let us not giggle. Let us cackle.
Cackling and hiding. Listen to us. It's like children's theater for 40-year-old gay people.
Hello? Is anybody here? This place is empty, right? Must just be some mice. Giggling and cackling mice. Is anybody here? Is there a light in here? I just broke in because I wanted to see what my dream almost happened. Hey! What are you doing? Oh, it's you. The artsy fartsy from my office. This is private property. Oh, don't worry, I'm just leaving. Where's that girl? The one from my office. She's a remarkable girl. You don't see a face like that every day. She is one foxy lady. How old would you say she is? 24, 25, 60? Dude, I would say somewhere in there. What is your case?
My case? My case? I'll tell you what my case is. It's this idea you had. The two of you had. It was her idea too. Concerts here, right?
Oh, it's gonna be more than just concerts. I mean, it's...
See, why do you keep talking? Now you're annoying me. I had the idea long ago. Concerts in this theater. Classy stuff. Swing music and three girls singing in tight, tight harmony. Till tomorrow. If she and you were to work together on this, you really think you could make something of this old place?
Yeah, man, this could be awesome.
I'll tell you what, kid, if you really want this old theater, you fix it up by this afternoon, and I'll give you and the girl 25%.
But that's near impossible. Yeah, I knew you didn't have it in you.
Hey, well, if it's impossible, doesn't mean I'm not gonna do it. It means it might take a little while.
We'll get you thinking you're fancy, jumping and swinging from the rafters, making this place over thinking you're a regular Errol Flynn.
Oh, I don't know who that is.
But you don't. I have a bad feeling about this already. All right, Bright Eyes. You want this place, you fix it up by this, by sunset, tonight, and we're in business.
Yeah! Kira! Kira!
Sonny, what is it?
If we fix this place up by this afternoon, the owner says he'll let us have a quarter of it.
By this afternoon? And for a quarter of it?
Isn't it great?
No. That's a terrible deal. And the task is impossible.
Aw, Kira, this is it. My chance to create. Now come on, let's get to work. It's happening. It's all happening. I mean, my career as an artist is finally happening. I'm on the brink of complete and utter artistic fulfillment. Oh my goodness, the verge. The brink, the verge. Ah, oh gosh. I could use a fresco.
Now you have the enthusiastic. I'm as jumpy as a joey.
Now come on. Let's draw up the plans of what this place is gonna be.
Actually,
I... Here, you draw too.
I'm not allowed to. There's strict rules against.
All right. See? I'm drawing up plans. Here, draw the lobby for me.
Oh, I'm a terrible artist.
Here, draw.
Short time, maybe for all time, but it's there. No wonder if I was dealing with mortality life's own creation. I envy you.
Now come on, you're not such a bad drawer.
You think you're wonderful.
Really? Now, sister?
Possible. Restore this theater in the time allotted. Not even with the help of my four sisters who just happened by.
Sisters?
Ah, yes, my sisters, and this is not all of them. Sunny, meet Terpsichore, why she's a regular dancing fool. And this is Euterpe. She always has a song in her heart. And this is Talia, she loves comedy. And this is Irritol, she loves making up rhymes and lyrics.
What rhymes with Nantucket?
Music and dancing. Rhymes and a funny story. Our father always said, put them together and you'd have a musical comedy. But not even with the help of these most powerful sisters. It's not possible.
Not possible? Not to Sunny Malone. But stick with me, little ladies. A 1, 2, 3, 4.
Everybody all around the world, gotta tell you what I just heard. There's gonna be a party all over the world. Oh, oh. I got a message on the radio, but where it came from I don't really know. And I heard these voices calling all over the world.
You sound like a vaudeville team.
I don't get that joke. Why'd you give up on this place?
I'll tell you what, kid, I loved a girl. A heck of a girl. She inspired me. She brought out the best in me. But I wanted to make money, so I let go of a lot of my dreams. The next thing you know, the guy I was gone, and the girl I loved was gone, too.
Danny, enough about your personal life. How about this theater? I said I would fix this place up, and I did.
You did? Well, what do you say, partner?
Okay, but I warn you, I don't know the first thing about being a partner.
Well, it's easy. We share responsibilities, we argue a lot. It's like being married without the good part.
That's just wrong.
What do you say, kid? Is it a deal?
Okay, it's a deal.
Well, what do you know? I'm back in the show business.
Xanadu, did Kubicon a stately pleasure dome decree?
Where out the sacred river ran to caverns measureless to man down to a sunless sea. That's you, isn't it, Kitty?
My name is Kira.
Right, of course you're not, because if you were Kitty, you'd be much, much, you'd be my age now. Unless... If you are to ever see someone who looks a lot like you, only she's my age now, and goes by the name of Kitty and is Southern, you tell her that I loved her very much, and I was a fool, and I never loved again.
That would be a lot for me to say to someone I just met, but I am sure wherever she is, she hollers at.
Well, I'm gonna go see how the sign looks like in the back of the house.
This is all because of you, Kira, don't you feel it?
I feel so many things right now. Some most delightful, but actually a few humiliating, but most of them delightful.
Don't you feel that all your hard work is coming to fruition? Don't you feel the joy and just, you know, the relief that comes with creativity?
I feel...
There.
Sunny, your kiss! I feel something warm in my heart. Not unlike cognac. But something new and exciting. Something I feel will bring my destruction.
You're so Catholic.
I have a sense of promoting something terrible.
Come on, Sonny boy, you gotta see the sign from back here.
Sign?
The Xanadu.
Xanadu sign?
The Xanadu sign. People will see this and just die. Oh, they'll love it.
People love, die, Xanadu sign.
Come on.
Sonny, why don't you run down there with Danny and I'll stay here and put the last minute details.
Well, what if...
Go.
Hurry up, the sign is so clear. Anyone can see it from down here. All right, see you later.
Good night, mate.
Cloyo!
Oh, it is you, Hermes, fleet-footed messenger of the gods. What brings you to me, Hermes?
Cloyo, I bring you a message from Zeus.
Yes, Hermes?
He wishes to know if you have seen his sign.
I have seen the sign, Hermes.
He wishes to remind you that the penalty for creating art on one's own is eternal banishment in the netherworld.
I know that. You may tell Zeus.
He thirdly wishes to remind you that the penalty for loving a mortal is eternal damnation in the netherworld.
Hermes, why does Zeus tell me these things? I love no one. I have created nothing. I'm a loveless and uncreative being. Why does Zeus accuse me so? Why, Hermes? Why?
Bitch, I don't know your life.
Zeus, I hear your warnings. So away I must run from the mortal Sunny Malone, who has stolen my heart.
Oh my, you would have to be blind not to see that sign just staring you in the face.
Sunny, please stop talking, it hurts.
Hey, Kira, don't be a bummer now.
Bummer I am and bummer I shall be. I must take my leave of you.
Leave of me? Like, leave me?
Sunny, I must go.
What? The whole Xanadu thing. You can't leave. I need you here.
You can do it without me, surely. And when the Xanadu Club opens and is thriving, you must take a moment and reflect upon us. And wherever I may be, just know that we'll have this roller disco together.
Yeah, but I need you just to be around.
Oh, stuff and nonsense. We only met a Marmon earlier. We don't know each other well enough to have any significant ties. Do we?
Well, I guess you're right and all, but don't walk away.
Oh, Son of Alara, why do you talk to me in this semi-intimate manner?
And why do I say, don't walk away? You'll be the way you were before when you
bye.
M-E-W-S. I'm an M-U-S-E. Muse. A muse inspires an artist.
Well, you are. You are my muse. You've inspired me.
All cards on the table now, Clio!
Well, all right. In the modern mortal age in which you dwell, the word muse has taken on a more metaphorical use as a person who inspires another person. I am not that. In ancient Greece, Father of the God Zeus did lay down with Titaness Mnemosyne on 9 consecutive nights and sired 9 daughters.
Wait, what are you saying?
She's saying she's a demigod, bonehead.
Seriously?
Am I the only one here who gets it?
Clio, I don't believe what you say.
But you love me.
I love you, but I don't believe you.
I'm confused by the ways of mortals. How can there be love when there is not trust? I tell you, Sunny, that I am a muse.
And I tell you, schizophrenia is nothing to be ashamed of.
Wait, it gets even worse. Melpomene and I.
Muse of tragedy.
Muse of epic.
We were extremely jealous of our sister.
So we whimsically placed a curse upon the two of you.
What?
Fall in love.
Wait, what are you saying?
You weren't really in love in the first place.
A curse? But it feels so real. Sunny, don't believe them. I know I'm in love with you, for it is verity itself.
Huh. Actually, that curse part, that makes sense.
So afford me a moment of clarity. You don't believe I'm a muse, but you do believe my sister's placed a curse on you?
Hey, the one on the right looks seriously witchy-poo.
I try to dress simply and let my personality be the star.
But this is real, genuine love.
Can you prove it?
Well, no.
See?
Well, fie upon you, Sonny Malone.
Fie!
Yeah, fie!
For you are such a fool. I can only use words to express it.
Aw, don't!
Tell him in a song.
Whatever you do, you remind me. Wherever you go, you will find me. I really don't want love, so save all your stuff. Ooh, I won't be needing any knock for a while. I really don't want love, so save all your stuff. Ooh, I won't be needing any knock for a while. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Sisters, we return.
For we feel something heavy is going down.
I'm
a fool.
Wherever you go, you're a loser.
Fool.
I want you to know you're a user. I'm really down on love, so save all your smile. Fool, I won't be needing any, not for a while. I'm really down on love, so save all your smile. I've announced my very muse-ness to a mortal.
No!
I have also allowed myself to fall in love with this mortal.
Never!
And in my most blatant defiance of Zeus, I have created art myself and enjoyed it.
Oh, no, you didn't!
Okay, look, now I've had it. This is really cute, this little cult thing y'all got going on. But I'm sorry. I don't believe any of you are from ancient Greece.
Dude! We speak in unison. How much proof do you need?
Huh?
He believes not. So back into that pavement chalk mural, I must journey. The pavement chalk mural that is crude and amateurish.
Hey!
And there, Pegasus shall take me to Mount Olympus, where I shall receive my proper punishment.
Then we shall leave also. We shall return to the mural. Let this year, the year 1980, be known as the year all inspiration
left the arts.
And we shall leave as well, smug in our confidence.
Goodbye to you, Kira or Bio. I really thought we had something there, man.
And I see the early glow. I hear you say hello. I watch the shadows fall, and I don't see you at all.
I don't believe it's all.
And I see the autumn rain falling on my window pane, and I hear you say goodbye, and I see a tear in your eye.
Threaten you with violence, so I've taken liberty of calling my lawyers and... Wait, did you just say okay?
Kira, the girl who was my inspiration. It turns out she's crazy.
Well, when you're working with Crave, it's 50-50.
No, like certifiably. She said her name was Clio, and she was really a muse from ancient Greece. She said she came out of the drawing I did, and now has gone back. And she's waiting for Pegasus to fly into Mount Olympus.
A muse, huh? Well, I could explain how I've known her so long ago and why she'd stay forever young. Maybe my whole life has taken a sudden, extreme spiritual turn. That sometimes happens to rich people. Not often.
She's crazy. She said she loved me.
She said she loved you. You and not me. She must be crazy. This is absurd. We should just get on with our lives and forget about this nonsense.
Mind.
there it is, a horse in the sky. A Pegasus and on its back Kitty, looking just as she did the day she left me.
It's Kira.
Kitty is Kira. They're both Clio. That's what life is. Crazy like this sometimes. I have to go stop that wrecking ball. You have to go after her.
But I can't get into the mural. The rain just washed it away.
Don't make the same mistake I made. Love her like I wish I had back then. Go after her.
There's nothing but a brick wall.
And when is it falling in love like banging head against a brick wall? I have to go save that theater.
And I shall go to Mount Olympus. Even if it's very far and
in the Mediterranean.
But how can our hearts see?
A miracle is what we need.
And so I appeal to you. To keep me suspended in time with you. Don't let this moment die. Not get a feeling when I'm with you.
Sisters, and she must suffer the consequences.
Zeus, my lord, father of all gods, master of the universe, and holder of all lightning, I am Thetis, I am a goddess of the sea, and I know things. I look into the eyes of this child and know it is not a curse, but actual love.
I know this as well, but my only evidences are my feelings. These same feelings that torture me so painfully.
She's got it bad. And that is not good.
I shall now proclaim my sentence. Eternal banishment in the netherworld.
Stay your hands, my lord, for I shall present existence of actual love that can be proven not with feelings, but with hard evidence.
What? How?
Impossible.
If she gets this, she's good.
Zeus, I remind you of my son Achilles, the greatest warrior of all Greece, and how he was destroyed by Paris, who shot his arrow straight through Achilles' heel, thus killing him. For as you may recall, all of the gods' offsprings are dipped into the river Styx, but they are held by their ankles so that their only weak spot is their ankles.
I remember this, Thetis, but not
Zeus,
see
her. I appeal to you. Look at the attire Clio has donned, the woolen woven fabric she has placed around her ankles.
The lebomers.
But of course. But of course, no curse can penetrate this demigoddess. Not with these mighty leg warmers around my ankles.
Oh, if only I had gotten in leg warmers for my brave son Achilles.
Then it is true. Love has triumphed. Cleo truly did fall in love with that mortal.
I don't care. She will be banished anyway.
Oh, my Zeus, my mighty, mighty Zeus. Think with your heart, not your brain.
Have you never let it stop?
never have time to lay back, kick your shoes off and close your eyes. I was like you. You're not hard to
Oscar Award winner, Maggie Smith. I'll fight these bunch of hams for you any day.
Sunny, these are real gods.
But this is just like the movie.
If they resembled actors you've seen on film, that just shows the art of filmmaking.
Those are really gods?
Yes. We are gods, and I'm not amused!
I don't care. I will fight anyone or anything to be with the woman I love.
You would fight Zeus for your love? You would dare to fight me?
Yes, I would. I love her that much.
Well, I've never seen that before. Someone who loves that much. And Clio, do you love this mortal?
All of my heart.
And would you willingly give up all your powers, even immortality?
Kira.
I would.
But Clio, this is 1980. The muses are in retreat. Creativity remains stymied for decades. The theater, they'll just take some stinker movie or some songwriter's catalog, throw it on stage, and call it a show.
Then I shall take the improbably popular art forms at each moment of time. A stage adaptation of the inferior cinematic classics, the music of the box that is Juke, and I shall use them to show mankind that there is more to life than wealth and fame. That is the human experience rendered comprehensible through art.
I love you so much.
How lovely. Nata Miglaya. Are the big hands and the big feet telling me the story that I want to hear?
Yeah.
Clio, if you so choose to go down this path, what shall you do?
I shall start this quest today on Earth with a roller disco.
Then so be it. Clio, you must now live on Earth as a mortal, and as an Australian.
Thanks, mate.
Now, before you leave me forever, one final gift.
No!
No more further gifts, I implore you.
Let anyone who hears of the quest stand at you hear how it's epic and a tragedy.
Be gone with you! The quest for Xanadu will end shortly and be happy.
Shortly? Happy? I am outraged! Calliope is outraged as well and would be here but for the constraints of Castum.
There's not a ton I can offer you, Kira. Just that I love you, and you can create whatever you want to.
Myopic mortal, that is the greatest achievement any of you might hope for. To love someone else, and to create art. That is Xanadu.
That is Xanadu! Thank you, Father Zeus, for the greatest gift of all, for Xanadu!
Shooting!